We're going to start off just really doing the basics of laser water plastering. So I want to make sure Max is comfortable and that she's not in any pain. So how's your pain at the moment?
Not too bad.
Okay, well, had some pain relief.
I've had some more pain relief. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
And do you understand what we're going to do? We're going to put a backslab on your wrist today.
Okay.
Because you have a break in this wrist portion here.
Right, okay.
So what I'm going to do is just have a look at Max's skin as well, just to check that she has no wounds on there, so she doesn't need any dressings on. I'm also going to check the cat refill to make sure that is all okay. She's also undressed and ready to go, because obviously if we did put a backslab on there and then she had a thick jumper on, it would be quite difficult to remove that over the top of the cast. So I'm also protecting myself, I'm protecting my patient with the cover, okay, so we don't get dirty. Also, we need to think of our backs when we're doing any sort of plastering, so we're just going to raise you up in there, if that's okay.
That's fine.
And I'm also going to check that Max has got no ring on her finger there, which she hasn't. Okay, so I'm going to get all my equipment ready. So I need some lukewarm water here. And bring that close to the patient. So there are two reasons why we can put a below elbow backslab on in our department. It's for a fracture to the wrist area, so the radius of the fracture, or it could be for a suspected scaphoid fracture. Okay. So what I need is a roll of padding. Now all our measurements that we have in our folder here are based on the average adult size, but we can actually adjust these. If we're plastering a child, we can adjust the sizing, or if we had a larger adult, we could change the size of that. But I'm just going to run through it with what fits you today, Pam.
Okay.
Mags. So this is a 10 centimetre soft band here.
Okay.
That we're going to pop on. And I'm actually going to put the padding on first. I'm going to start at the top here, just above the elbow, and I'm going to put two layers around the top so we have a nice soft turn back. And we're just going down the arm there, 50-50. And then we get to here, we're going to make a little break in the padding around the thumb area there. And again. There we are. So I've now got a nice turn back, so I've got two layers at the top. Gather all my little loose ends in there. And then I can finish off just by tearing the padding. Okay. Also, what I want to do is just to protect here, the ulna styloid. In some people, it's quite prominent and they're very at risk of getting a sore over there. So we can use some Silona here, which is just a felt. So I'm going to just cut off a square to start with. And then I'm going to turn that into a circle. Pop that over the styloid there. And that will just prevent any sores happening. Okay, so now I'm going to prepare my backslab. So I'm going to start here at the metacarpal heads. And I want to cut the plaster to about two fingers below the joint there, because what we don't want is any rubbing in the crease there when the patient bends their elbow. So we have a 15 centimetre and a 20 centimetre backslab here. They're already cut into five pieces, so we can just cut the length of it. We don't need to worry about the layers. And we need to do some shaping. So pop in that just onto the metacarpal heads there, and we need to cut a semicircle out. And I'll be able to move her thumb around. And to check that all fits. What I'm going to do is just soften the edges at the top here, just so there's no sharp edges at the end there to prevent it rubbing. Just going to check that it's all okay. And going to shape that a little bit, just so because the metacarpals just go down at an angle, so I'm just going to take a little bit off there so it doesn't come over the top of the metacarpal head. So. Everything ready to go. And I need to put my bandage in just to pre-soak. If you put it on dry and then you get some shrinkage, it's going to become too tight for the patient. So if you pre-soak it first, that will prevent it happening. Okay, ready to go. So as I said, my water is lukewarm. Take hold of my plaster, keep the ends together, pop it in, keeping hold of the ends. And I'm just going to do a little squeeze. I want to keep some moisture in there. Make sure it's all nice and straight now because I don't want any creases inside. And then I'm going to pop it onto Mag's wrist. And pop that little one through there. Making sure it's not rubbing against the thumb. Smoothing around the wrist. We just need to make sure we laminate the edges together. Also it moulds it around the wrist there. Okay. So I'm now going to turn back my ends. So I'm going to start bandaging around the wrist just to anchor it on. It's going to come through near the thumb there. Just going to give it a little squeeze together. Around again, catching all the ends of the padding, making sure we've got no rough edges around the thumb there, and then we can head on down the arm. Capture those edges at the top there, a nice smooth edge, and then I'm going to tie that off. A little knot just to stop the bandage tearing anymore. Tie it around. And I'm just going to tie a little knot there. We just need to make sure that knot is away from the fracture site. So I need now Mags just to keep her arm nice and still. Okay, just going to just go a little mould to make sure that's all snug. And I need to keep still now just to allow that plaster to start to harden. Are you okay there?
Yes, lovely.
And while that is happening, I'm just going to give Mags a little clean, just get rid of any plaster that is against the skin. I'm going to just dry that off. Okay. So when that has had a chance to harden off a little bit, I'm just going to check the circulation again by doing cat refill. Make sure Mags is nice and comfortable. So I'm going to hold for 5 seconds there. And then release. Okay, and the circulation came back there very quickly. Make sure it's not rubbing, so 2 fingers there.
That's fine.
Rubbing. And the metacarpal heads are free, so you'll be able to move those.
Yeah.
You can move your thumb around there and it's not rubbing against
the straw. Not at all, no.
No, lovely. Before Mags would leave the department and this cast has had time to harden off, I'd need to give her some advice. So we have our fracture clinic booklet here. And in the front here, we'd need to write the diagnosis and treatment. And then whether the patient needs to return to the plaster room at all for the plaster to be completed. If you're in any doubt at all, in the plaster completion book over here, we have the below elbow back slab, and on here it talks about all distal fracture, ranges fractures are completed, unless they are elderly and frail, then there is no need to complete them. So that's going to be a judgment on the day, really, as to how frail your patient is and whether you need to complete that or not. So discuss it with the MP if you're unsure about it, or the doctor who's prescribed the plaster. Then we just need to give Mag some advice about looking after herself. So we need to advise you if you're getting pins and needles, any numbness, blueness in your fingers there, if you become sore or rubs at all, any excess swelling or pain, you need to contact us. And there's some phone numbers in this book for you to contact us. Fracture link is open in the daytime, up until 8 o'clock in the evening, and then overnight you need to contact the emergency department, and the phone number is in there for that as well.
Okay.
Mags will need to allow the plaster to dry naturally, okay, so no hair dryers, no sticking it in front of fires, just allow it to dry naturally. We'll pop you into a sling, okay, that would need to be kept on for a few days until it's nice and dry. And also when you're in bed at night, just make sure you put you on the pillow, take the sling off, it'll be a bit more comfortable for you. Your bed may get a little bit wet if that plaster is against your bed sheets, so if I put it on the pillow, that will help. Okay, so don't put anything down there, no knitting needles, you know, it will get sometimes a bit itchy down there, but just try and resist temptation to pop something down there, because you may do sort of further damage or damage the plaster.
Okay.
Okay. And any concerns, as I say, just contact us. Okay.
Thank you very much.